Is that clear? I hope that's clear because, people work too hard to fulfill their intentions and they make exacting plans, they have driving ambition, and their ego gets in the way and they get all stressed out. And then, of course, even if the intention is fulfilled through hard work and driving ambition and exacting plans, it has created so much stress that you're not able to enjoy the fruit of your intentions.
Trappist 1F is likely the best positioned for life. The red sun in its sky would look larger than ours does to us, but less than 1/100th as bright. It could be warm there, though. Like tussling siblings, seven worlds so near to one another probably jostle one another's orbits. They try to keep in resonance. Their orbital periods pulled into whole number relationships. But those gravitational tugs could power up tides, keeping these worlds warm.
As well as we should have. And now what's happening is fascinating. Today's biggest AI breakthroughs are of a completely different kind, where rather than the intelligence being largely programmed in and easy to understand code, you put in almost nothing except a little learning rule by which a simulated network of neurons can take a lot of data and figure out how to get stuff done. And this deep learning suddenly becomes able to do things often even better than the programmers were ever able to do. You can train a machine to play computer games with almost no hard-coded stuff at all. You don't tell it what a game is, the things are on the screen, or that there even is such a thing as a screen. You just feed in a bunch of data about the colors of the pixels and tell it, hey, go ahead and maximize that number in the upper left corner, and then gradually you come back and it's playing some game much better than I could.
But I wonder if people have really thought it through. Einstein's theory of relativity points out that time itself is relative. Prior to Einstein, we thought that time is absolute, that the passage of time is the same on our planet as it would be on any other planet. But Einstein's discovery, to put it simply, is this: the faster you go, the slower time goes, so that if you're traveling at the speed of light, say if you're a photon or you're riding on a photon, time stops completely. So that means a photon can travel from one end of the universe to the other. And that distance is many, many billions of light years. So if we were on Earth watching the passage of a photon across the universe, it would take many, many billions of years according to our clocks. But the person riding on that photon would experience no passage of time at all. And if a human being were in a spaceship traveling at the speed of light, if that were possible, that person wouldn't age. Billions of years could pass by on Earth, but not for that time traveler, that space traveler.
But I was uneasy about it a little bit. The reason I was uneasy about it is I couldn't really figure out where the rules came from. Did they come from some basic formulas like Schwinger was working with? I couldn't tell. It was just too hard to tell, and I was disturbed by it, and I was uneasy about it. Well, fortunately for me, and I think for a whole generation of physicists, somebody else had put the ideas together, and managed to understand exactly how to go from Schwinger's deep fundamental principles to Feynman's tricks to Feynman's diagrams. Who was that somebody? Well, you just heard him speak a moment ago. It was Freeman Dyson. And Dyson, Feynman, Schwinger, and Tomonaga laid the basis for quantum electrodynamics, for quantum field theory, and for our own entire future understanding of particle physics. To teach the lesson that the jargon, the mumbo-jumbo, the overly precious mathematics, the overly abstract mathematics, generally did not help you think about phenomena. The way to think about phenomena, well, maybe you don't close your eyes, but you think about the phenomena themselves, and then you convert it to mathematics. You use the simplest tools that you can. Whatever the simplest tools are, if you use those, you will learn the most about the physics.